Hallelujah.
Ain't got a dime, but I got the time. You make me happy when skies are gray.
That looks like Lisa.
Is that Lisa? Lisa McCracken.
Embrace the moments and share just the tranquility of these precious moments.
But I've got the time. Just keep rolling.
Peter!
This is beautiful. What a beautiful day. What a beautiful day. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Okay. Oh, hey. Woo! Just a, you know, a kid's bike, you know. Oh. Okay. Oh, ho, ho. What's this? Oh, that's nice. I park my car up here to keep it as far away from the tweakers as I can, you know? Oh, this is what it's like every Sunday. Whoa, once a week. Oh, look at this, this is mint. Darn. Oh. Look at that, that's 5 speeds, man. Socrates' last words were, "We owe Ascephalus a cock." And that was the funniest thing, man, because he had a sense of humor. He was being condemned to death for blaspheming the Greek gods, you know? That was part of the reason he was sentenced to death.
A couple of more.
I'm gonna need a bit of first for the wine there.
Oh, 26.49.
Yeah.
Nah!
Hallelujah.
Is this amazing?
Ah, oh, Mario, my car is virtually destroyed. Hallelujah. Now, I got the vodka for people going through the shakes or just need a shot, you know what I mean? Hallelujah. And I could drive my SUV right up to here and load and unload if I want, because I got a disability.
Okay.
You know, we've met.
That was worth it. Spiral ham, look at that.
Well, it's delicious.
That's wow.
We usually have church picnic in a picnic area every Sunday. And
oh, really?
Yeah.
We could have some a kid's party here a little bit.
Oh, yeah? Look, we'll just try to be on one side.
No, that's not going to work for us. We rented the area.
Oh, the whole area. Okay, okay.
What'd you say?
We own this town. Thanks to Jesus, we own it.
Oh, there you go. Yeah. There's going like.
got the beer.
Peter is like an ancient memory. He's like a sound that comes out of the rocks, and it can never die.
Thank you, Greg. I've known the Admiral for like, I guess 25 years. And he used to feed people here every day. He used to go out in the street on the highway off ramps with a sign saying, you know, work for food, right?
So do you live in a boat now?
No, right now I'm homeless by choice.
By the way, I want to give the Admiral a gift in front of you. This is my homemade jewelry.
Damn.
And this is this is like a finger picking ring. It's actually for cleaning. It is actually, what did I make this for? I forgot what I made it for.
That's fucking scary, Peter. I don't even want it.
I know.
You didn't make that.
I made that.
How the fuck did you make that?
Damn. I didn't know you could do that.
That's really good.
Yeah.
That's really good. Scary, though. It's too scary for me.
And you shall take a perfect male lamb in its first year. See that evil is before your faces. Moses said to him, you are correct. For on the day that you see my face, you shall die.
Okay, here we go. Now, okay. We're in the front of the Sausalito Public Library, and we're not here to torch the place. We're here to light the world up for Jesus Christ. We meet here every Sunday from noon to midnight, protesting nonviolently against all the homelessness and destruction of people's boats, you know, without proper, without due process. Welcome to the Waterfront Church of Sausalito. Hallelujah. Oh, my goodness. And look, I have to hike, go up this mountain like Moses. You know, I have to walk sideways to my back, you know.
You want to put a hand on my shoulder?
No, okay. I'm fine. No. I do this all the time. We'll do this all the time. Give expecting nothing in return. Give until it hurts. Don't give just out of your excess. Give until it hurts. Pain is very important, but just like anything, too much pain is not good. I mean, there are people in San Francisco, they pay people to whip them and give them pain, you know, whip them and beat them and tie them up and humiliate them and urinate on them. I mean, hey, a spanking would be nice. That's very simple. But yeah, let's leave it at a nice spanking, you know what I mean? Two more years, I'll be out here 40 years, and I'll be like Moses. I mean, I will be the Moses of San Francisco Bay. Really, two more years, it'll be 40 years exile. 40 years I've been exiled.
Wow. The people who live,
it sucks. Yeah. I hate paying. I'm ready to move everything out of here because the taxes.
Go. No. We're not ready to move out. We're going to clean it up because California belongs to all of us, and it's beautiful.
It's tough with luck.
I got a lot of problems I'm trying to solve. Solving the homeless boat problem is not one of the problems I'm trying to solve. It's a problem. It looks to me like nobody has a job or a way to support themselves, but they got to find a way to participate with society, which they're not doing. Mm-hmm. You know, you can't live like that. Mm-hmm. They're crapping in the water. Those are inhumane living conditions out on those boats. Those things are awful.
Yeah. I think that if you tried to get to the core of it, you might be surprised that the person you're talking to who they really are. And, you know, but they're resentful of their boss at their job, their landlord, the bank that's, you know, wants them, you know, sends them a bill for their Visa card every, you know. I think this, one of the things that we all carry is a propensity to say, it's not my fault.
Oh, Brazil is it's very nice. I have a lot of things, but here is very, I like here. Here in California, I feel like the people here is, I don't know why I like more California. Here I just feel good here.
Fuck authority. Fuck authority. Anointment in the oil.
It's a documentary on Sausalito.
Yeah.
Sure, so the standard operating procedures that are attached to the second resolution in your packet tonight do include the process for storage of personal belongings.
So I would encourage us to be parsimonious with our belief of how much we can control.
I recommend that you do not pass this poorly crafted resolution.
We need to really rethink some very profound things about our zoning and our planning.
Restore the boats that these people had been living on.
Stop crushing boats.
I am concerned about the overflow of homelessness that will eventually happen if we don't figure out something that works.
So the homeless encampment in Sausalito originally sort of evolved in January, I think, or of 2021. So the original person who put up a tent was somebody that had been chronically homeless for a long, long time. And then we reduced the number of boats on Sausalito waters from 90 to 9 in about 18 months. We created a safe harbor program.
That's my home! Everything I own is in there! That's my life!
And unfortunately, like I said, a couple of boats became so damaged that those people migrated ashore.
I guess I'm going to Tent City.
Right there on Dusty Park?
Dude, I have nowhere else to go. Yeah. My home and my life was in, there's my paddle.
Sausalito waters were much safer and much less congested with marine debris. It's absolutely one of the most sensitive habitats in San Francisco Bay. And one of the big reasons that we came up with our plan, right, to help reduce the number of boats on the bay and fill on the bay and the impacts, reduce the negative impacts of on the eelgrass, but also habitats, right?
Is it a lot of pressure being mayor?
Yeah, of course, especially in Sausalito because, it's always a challenge.
Hello, am I talking? Can anybody see me? Can I?
Yes, yes, sir.
Are we there? Thank you. Just simply want to make a very short statement. This entire property has been acquired because this is a religious assembly. You and I are now under strict judicial scrutiny.
I am willing to be arrested here defending this land, and if you persist in interfering, then you will be subject to litigation. I want to end by giving you a little bit of Torah. Moses could not deal with everything by himself. He called Jethro, his father-in-law and made up with his wife.
Excuse me, Mr. Chase, I'm sorry your 3 minutes is up. If you can
Thank you very much. Shabbat shalom.
Our goal was always to house people. That was always our goal. Our goal was always, and our stated conclusion was that living in the open in a tent in Sausalito is not an acceptable option for addressing those without shelter.
Amen.
Love is the law. Anything else is against the law.
Love is the law.
Love is the law.
That's his house. That's his house. He can go back there. That's his house. Stop touching him, officer. Officer, don't put your hands on that man.
This land is our land. This land is your land. From the Redwood Forest to the New York Harbor.
Today, a homeless camp in Sausalito was cleared out despite those living there putting up a fight.
They're not evicting this group. They're simply moving them to Marin Ship Park.
I'm 64 years old. I'm disabled. I'm a citizen of this country, and I'm being treated like dirt. We demand our rights. I have arthritis. I can't sleep. I haven't slept in a week. It's too cold.
This is where I live. This tent right here I bought on sale for $49 at the Big Five. Unfortunately, I'm on high ground, but I mean, don't get off into this wet stuff because it's contaminated with feces. Watch out, stay over this way. Don't walk in that, okay? So right now we're up to our ankles in feces. This is Rob.
Yep.
How's that ham and carrots?
It's good.
Got garlic in there, y'all. This is a shithole. Trump talks about shithole countries. This is a shithole town. They should change the name of this town from Sausalito to Shithole California.
Camp Cormorant, yeah, it was right on the water. That one, as a pedestrian, you kind of walked more kind of just to one side of it, and it had a little bit of a hill on the inside. That was kind of naturally, you know, circumscribed in its space.
But, you know, they were causing too many issues. There was like smoke and partying, and the police had to come. And
I did see explosions down there from my house.
Explosions?
Yeah.
I don't think it was a massive explosion, but something, you know, exploded in the camp that someone had.
We got women and children and elderly, disabled people living out here in the muck and the mire, while these middle-class, bourgeois, hippy-dippy fuckheads live up in there in this unprecedented luxury. No, I'd rather be down here in the feces.
There are people here who've had their boats crushed while they're at work or shopping. And
did you used to live in a boat?
Yeah, they crushed my boat when I went to jail. They put me on probation because a big-ass dude punched my girlfriend in the face. I beat the shit out of him with a rigging knife, woke me up, and I was like, who the fuck? And fucking click, click, handcuffs, go to jail. So.
That's the stupidest thing I've ever heard. They should be encouraging people to be out there on boats. What do people do when they come ashore? They spend fucking money. Yeah, money, you communist bitch-ass punks. Listen to this bullshit. Fucking Paul McCartney talking all this crap with $4 billion. No hell
below us. The fuck? I hate that music. That Beatles crap.
Yeah, I don't like music. I like rap. I hate music. I like gangster rap. A lot of, like, police background noise and gunfire and shit. Shotgun pump being, that kind of rap. Part of the South I come from is a rat's nest. It's a nasty place.
Anyway, it's a very beautiful moon tonight. Yesterday I noticed that it was a beautiful moon too. I'm a dreamer, right? I don't live in a house. I live right now here and there the way I can. I'm homeless. And I am trying to be okay this winter. Every being in this world deserves that. I think it's true, every animal, every being.
The issue is that when boats anchor in eelgrass, when they drop that ground tackle there, they're going to remove and destroy the eelgrass below them. It's kind of like an underwater meadow. That chain basically acts as a lawnmower through the eelgrass.
That causes, you know, these kind of crop circles that you can see. And so, you know, it's pretty clear from the aerial photos that this is happening.
The herring will actually lay their eggs directly on the blades, and then other animals will come eat those herring. And that's why we've established the eelgrass protection zone. And everywhere in that, there's no anchoring for any amount of time.
They want to get rid of us over eelgrass, which is ridiculous. It's laughable. I mean, I could die laughing just thinking about it. You know, I mean, what a way to die. Oh, yeah, you're going to destroy the maritime way of life that's been here for hundreds of years over eelgrass, please. And the eelgrass is growing out of control.
Well, you've got to take it seriously to be taken seriously.
Oh, we're...
We've got to get the documentation together. I'll start doing research and printing stuff out.
Great. We got the authorities on the back of their heels. They don't know what to do. All they want is money. Whoa, we got to do. Here, I got it better. Yeah. Ooh, do. Yeah, no, it's, no. I don't want to stab it. Salted pork.
It's a pocket dimension of hell where love is not allowed to thrive and exist. It's sort of hampered in any way, shape, or form by the, this, you know, by all us, by ourselves even.
Why
did I throw the fire over? I don't remember that.
I don't know.
I was just also going, whoops, weird. Look at my tongue.
They're mites. They're called Sicarvi scavi, is a Latin word, but they're from the South Pacific. They're not standard. They're resistant to treatment. Very, very fucking resistant. These you can get 4,000 individual blind bugs eating you alive per gram of skin. But for 2.5 years, I haven't gotten them off my chin somewhere. They've just been there.
They kept me in handcuffs in the hospital on the CAT scan I didn't agree to, in pain. You know how that is when you lay in on your handcuffs for like 5 hours.
Yeah, I'm trying to do, man.
Yeah.
The history about it is interesting too, because for decades the RBRA did not care about eelgrass. RBRA never mentioned it. Only recently has the RBRA started to represent itself as a conservation or environmental conservation agency. Like right here, this is all eelgrass habitat, and these marinas and the Army Corps destroy all the eelgrass habitat right here through dredging. They literally just dig out the bottom of the seafloor. Yes, the people who are destroying the boats to save the eelgrass are destroying eelgrass through dredging.
Oh, gently on the doors. Close the doors gently. Watch this. That's how I want you to always close these doors. Now, I'm going to close your door before I want to show you something. Just like this. About like that. Never touching the paint, never touching the glass.
Very delicate.
Yeah, well, and then people see you do that, and they'll go, wow, this guy's used to being around really good cars. Da, 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 da. Fucking dumpster. Look how the dumpster's way out there. Like, it's not hard enough to fucking come in here like it is, see? I hate that shit. Look, I get parking here, I get secure parking, so I can't bitch.
The city of Sausalito declared a state of emergency over a homeless camp, and now that camp is no more. And city leaders are now moving forward with new plans for that area.
We are not ruled by the building code. We are not here because of their permission or his. He lets his job go to his head. God bless you. I don't want you to lose, actually.
The city apparently wants to move them to these tennis courts right near the area.
They put it in the tennis courts because the reasoning being that you wouldn't be standing on the leach field, you know, with all the raw sewage bubbling out of the grass. We moved to hold the city in contempt of court because they'd promised people would be safe over here. And in fact, they had put people into serious danger, and people got really sick because of what the city did.
And then they took over, you know, a beautiful tennis court that, you know, we paid for.
Do you play tennis?
Yeah. I want my tennis court back.
I would not go by the tennis court.
She's a golden retriever chihuahua.
Whoa.
And it's like $2,000 a dog. So they have to artificially inseminate the retriever with the chihuahua sperm. And you know, nobody wants to jack off a chihuahua, so you gotta pay highly for that.
There it is.
Everybody has their own style, which is interesting, you know. You can maybe take a little bit of this guy's style and adapt it to your style and then make it, you know, extra.
Hell yeah.
Because it's your style and his style, you know.
You know, I've gone through 3 boats that I've lived on. 3 times my home has been destroyed completely. And I've been stuck in a park, sitting on a bench, having to start from scratch. You know what that feels like? Right. It's fucking brutal. In California, it's pretty brutal.
I was living on a boat in Richardson Bay for 24 years. Actually, 5 different boats. They crushed all 5 of my boats, one at a time. The last one was after the pandemic hit in 2020. You know,
yeah.
All I know is that you can't hack this, and what I'm doing now.
What are you doing now?
I'm crocheting. I taught myself how to do a cable stitch. I didn't know it. I thought I invented it. See the yellow I'm just putting on? It's gonna be a sunset right there in the background. Yeah. I only charge $40, enough to cover, you know, it cost me $5 to go poop, minimum. Well, I'm not that kind of guy that I just shit on the fucking sidewalk like some of these people around here. I've got more class than that. Right? So I go into an establishment where I pay for a service of the facility like any other decent human being on the planet. But, Peter. Peter's a good guy. He means well. He means well. He's a little delusional at times, but he will send you to hell in the name of Jesus. Poor Peter.
He's still out there.
Is he?
Yeah.
Well.
Yeah, this is awesome.
Hey, come on in. Look, don't be shocked. This is really primitive. It's rough. It's cold. You go through storms, but you know what? Hey, look at the view. Look at the view we got. Look at the view.
Okay.
I just never took the time.
on my mind. You were always.
I have this gift of photographing supernatural beings in the clouds, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's just a distinct form of clouds, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Where you have a sixth sense. You know in that band of clouds, there are angels. Check this one out. Isn't that cool? You know, neat face in the cloud. This one is really cool. If you really look at it, the Father God is making a cloud out of his mouth. This is really neat. This is like, you know, expelling a demon. It's hard to see, but Jesus is under a wing in his hair. You can hardly see this, but there's actually an angel up here in a rainbow. Face up there like of a pirate, you know, of a celestial buccaneer. Not a pirate, but a buccaneer. And
this is
a picture of
what looks like God. This is Bruce. That's me and Bruce back in the day. 1977, that picture was taken.
Which one's you?
The guy with the dreadlocks.
Oh, no way.
Mm-hmm.
On the national news one night, my mom calls me. I said, I just saw you on national news. I was getting hit in the back of the head with a friggin' water cannon, you know, and my dog's in the boat, and I'm trying to.
15 minutes,
huh? Yeah. And I was in court that day to answer a charge of failure to disperse a pain in the life.
At the end of a full day's work, the developer had succeeded in moving two boats. He had hoped to move four boats. They'll be back tomorrow.
Well, I was a young 18-year-old, man. I was doing all of them in here.
Now I come from
I started with my small boat, my first boat, in 1965.
Wow, man. Well, anyways, look, I'm gonna go get my car. I'm gonna take him on a, he needs, I'm gonna take him, anything he wants to do today, anything he wants to do.
Most people die at 75. The average age of death.
I have 10 more years to go.
Oh, and he's like legally blind and kind of legally deaf. And he's 88 years old.
Angel, 88 years old.
And I headed for that Frisco Bay.
Oh, I was stabbed in the face on a boat, off a boat. A guy showed up at a boat and stabbed me. I wasn't in the boat, but I shot him with a flare gun, and I shot him point blank in the chest. I should have shot him point blank in the mouth.
Vladimir Putin, hey. I love you.
Thanks, man. Nice to meet you, y'all.
So,
what's up?
Tell me, why are you riding on my rim?
I'm testing it out.
You're checking it out.
I took his front tire or his front rim just to see what it was like.
I mean, I don't know what you're gonna do with it except fuck it up.
You get so many G passes, it's ridiculous, and it's not
because
you're a G.
You might want to go get on the bag now.
We laugh about it, but then it's not funny. But he picks things up wherever he might be, whoever they might belong to, and he borrows them. And sometimes it turns into stealing because he likes it.
Well, it's not stealing.
Or because he uses it.
Borrowing without permission.
Is the moon waxing or waning?
Damn, Billy Joel night here.
Was it a full moon?
No.
Is it waxing or waning?
Oh, it's
later.
All right, Ryan.
I'm never coming back.
Good.
Yeah, nice pink tires.
How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Phil's my husband now.
Oh, awesome. You guys got married?
Yeah.
When did you guys get married?
A couple weeks ago? Mm-hmm. A month ago?
Oh, wow.
A
couple weeks ago in Lake County.
I want you to talk well.
Yeah, it was an accident. I was trying to make a flower and some girl saw it. She goes, I see a turtle. I go, you sure do. And the rest
you
should
grow a bunch more turtles.
He makes turtles out of pine cones.
Up and down the coast. I forget what time of year it is. You're coming down right now.
No, you can let go. It's hard to steer if you're holding on to it. This gentleman, how many years have you lived on your boat? 43 years. Oh, life ain't always easy, man. Oh, no, okay. Everybody thinks living on the water is easy. Okay.
Here we go.
Okay.
Oh, sorry. Oh, sorry. Hurry up. Welcome to the jungle.
Come on.
We got it.
Hallelujah.
Thanks for hallelujah. Thanks. Lord willing, see you Sunday.
I'll see you there.
Okay. And I got 2 lemon meringue pie, steak, chicken, beef dog.
The encampment has been in the city of Sausalito here for more than a year. The city feels it's a growing crisis and says it's too much for a small town to handle. This explosion happened last night, and this recent incident was the last straw for the city of Sausalito. Ugh.
I was walking along the pathway going home, and a tent blew up, and it blew me up. And my friend went to the hospital with 85% of his body burnt, all on fire. And I ran back into the fire to pull him out. He was in an easy chair. The chair was melting. The tent was melting on him. Everything was melting on him. But I saved him. I took him out. I started throwing propane tanks and butane cans out of the area that was in the flame fire. And I'm still in this frickin' wheelchair. Okay, so you think it's easy to get off the street? It's not. I could go into a shelter where I'd have to be kicked out every day and come in at night, and hopefully by the lottery I'll get another bed. Why? Why put me through such jump rope activity when I'm 60 fucking 6 years old?
Hey, Bob! Come here, I got the sheriff on the line. Come here! You're the one who wanted me to call. Bob is homeless and he doesn't have a phone. Bob, do you need an ambulance?
I just told her what's going on.
No, this is a different lady.
I'm telling you, it's a hit and run.
Yeah, the tennis court camp, the homeless tennis court camp that was closed down yesterday. Exactly. That's where we are right now. There weren't that many left. There's only about 10 people left, and they put them in housing or hotel rooms, and they're going to get permanent housing.
Let me talk.
Talk. Go ahead and talk. Don't get uppity. I'm doing you a favor. You know what? I've known him for 25 years, that man.
Who, Bobby?
Bobby from San Rafael. It's Locked the Lumber. He was a big deal back in the 90s.
Copy, I'm out with Bobby.
Now he makes pine cone turtles.
Yeah. So you didn't see anything?
No, sir. I wish I did. That's tragic. Look at that bicycle. So, yeah, everybody got paid. It's a victory for the people, thanks to the homeless union and our attorney. Yeah, 30 people got $18,000. Let's see. Whose money would that be? Yeah, it's going to come from the Sausalito taxpayers.
And I don't think it's such a smart idea that the city paid them $18,000 each. Because what, they're just gonna go and spend that on more drugs.
I have heard about that and it is effing insane.
Any one-time settlement that doesn't kind of solve the deeper issues here is really a little bit of a Band-Aid in my opinion.
But I do understand that it's not quite as insane as it sounds, because they're only going to pay for housing out of that, supposedly.
Everybody just got thrown to the wind, and they're all still looking for that community. Like, you know, we're looking for each other, you know, because it's like you destroy a village and you just scatter the people. What do they have to replace that community, you know? So.
Just send them down, Joe. I'll talk to them when you get here.
Hey, wait.
I'm okay. If I'm gonna gain my money, I'm gonna buy a boat. I'm gonna get whatever. I'm homeless. I'm gonna get 18,000 in a room. This is nothing just for me, it's just rock and roll.
Where do you think that everyone's gonna go?
They're gonna go the way of the four winds. I'm gonna blow some smoke in the air for all those who died. Right here on this spot. Had quite a few casualties. Let's see, come to think of it, I can't think of a single person. The ones I can think of were over at the other camp. Who died here? Damn, come to think of it, no casualties. Look at this fucking bird shit. Try to get the car at all times. You get in the front end of the car? Look at all that bird shit on there. Take a picture of some of this bird shit.
You ever get lonely?
I do. I'm lonely right now. Never been married, but I lived with a couple like we were married. No kids. I'm a one-woman man. Ugh, I am not a player. I'm not a player, a gangster, or a pimp. I'm a boss. And I just found out my great-grandmother, full-blooded Italian. That explains a lot. That explains why, once again, I am boss of a city. Yeah. You want to go eat dinner? I'm as alone in the world as you can get. Check this motherfucker out with Audi. He wants to drive fast. Watch his shit. There he goes. Now you're gonna go now. Wow. What are these people doing, really, you know, after 8 o'clock at night in these stupid houses they live in? You know, they're watching the big Samsung televisions. A lot of them watch sports. Well, most people are better off being homeless. They get some more natural lifestyle. So, but now that the camps are gone, completely gone, as of yesterday, Peter's Sunday soiree is like all we have left as a social thing. You see, that's how it is, really. It's all about the eelgrass and the birds. Are you noticing that? What the exposure that you're getting to all this?
Yeah.
Are you noticing that? I told them I think their $140,000 eelgrass study was a bunch of bilge water and horse feathers.
Hallelujah, you made it.
Hallelujah.
Another day in paradise. Let me just put this in here.
Glorious.
Amen. God bless you, brother.
Hey, Dan.
God bless
you. Oh, my goodness. Okay. Woo! Ha-ha. Okay.
They want to close our anchorage so we can't live on our boats. And so because of the eelgrass, they say we're destroying the grass, you know, the seaweeds. We're going to videotape Richardson Bay, and we're going to go into a flying boat. Okay. And we're going to go to fly over the bay and videotape and prove that the eelgrass is healthy on the bay and that the anchorites are not destroying the eelgrass on the bay.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, everybody. Seatbelts work just like they do in
the... Okay, thank you.
Metal clasp goes in the metal buckle.
Okay.
Please refrain from smoking anything.
Anything. Or vaporing. Vaporing.
Nothing at all.
Who, me?
Yeah.
No, vaping? No, 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 no. Oh. Oh, yeah. I got 74. I don't know. Okay, 74. Ah. Oh, I got it. Yeah, don't pull them inside the cabin. Got it. Oh man. Woo! And we're gonna show that we're not destroying the eelgrass. That the eelgrass is overgrowing the harbor, in fact. So we're going up to photograph the bay and to prove that we are not destroying the ecosystem. That was the best ride I've ever been on. That was the best. Wow. Yeah, well, the eelgrass population looks absolutely beautiful.
So, you know, we do have some responsibility to do what we can, right? To protect this habitat and return it. Does this look defensive? I got my arms crossed.
No, that looks good.
I gotta cover.
What can you tell me about Peter?
Gosh. He's someone that's been, you know, in and around Sausalito for a long time. And he is a colorful character. As you know, he usually has something interesting to say when he says it, and you know, that's, we kind of like that here in Sausalito.
He told me he ran for mayor like 10 times.
Yeah, you're talking about Peter Romanowski?
Yeah.
Sure. That's the great thing, right, about living in a democracy is that everybody has access to the process and, you know, welcome the debate, right?
I mean, you know, there are eelgrass huggers trying to get rid of us like they got rid of the loggers over the spotted owl, you know what I mean? Oh, there's my ex.
Oh, nice.
Hi, Becky.
Hi.
Hello.
I think it's...
Okay.
Probably still have five.
Well, I guess if you have the cash, I might as well put it in my wallet just in case. She's a treasurer of our church organization. The mother of my three children and my three grown children who are all university grads and have been, and I got three grandchildren, all girls. But anyways.
Get under the sink.
Oh, God.
Yep, there she goes.
How did the conversation go?
Excellent. We've only been divorced like 38 years, 9 years. I mean, what's that? You know what I mean?
It's not very long.
Nothing compared to eternity, right? Once we get back together, I'm going to be able to tell people, man, we've been divorced 40 years, and we forgave each other after 40 years, you know what I mean? I mean, that's what I want to look forward to.
I've been engaged, never married or divorced.
Yeah. That's...
Don't get married, but...
I want to be like...
Supermodel, Rocky. Supermodel.
But I know that guy doesn't keep his houseboat very clean either. My mom moved in with him for a little while.
Fuck Peter?
I don't think so. I don't think so. I don't think so. I'm telling you, I really don't think so.
She probably did.
No,
she
said
fuck Peter.
No, she said he's weird. He's a cross-dresser. All kinds of weird shit.
Fucking bastard scattered my
little tribe all over the place, and most of them will probably never come back. This is not a happy Christmas for me. So now it's all about saving the aristocracy. So come join our aristocracy. Costs nothing to join. You don't have to pay $40. We're not going to drag you through the mud, cut you with a knife, or piss on you. Come join the aristocracy.
Out here in a state of suspended animation, mentally, spiritually, physically, we are in a state of suspended animation. We're the cattle in the field, man. Now they're culling the herd, you know what I mean? But they'll never get rid of the whole herd, you know what I mean? We're just sheep for the slaughter. we're sheep for the slaughter.
Isn't it a pity? Isn't it a shame?
Hello, Hainu, Melikau, Lam. Asher Kedishanu, B'mitzvotav, Itzvanu, Nechad Li Chanukah.
And cause each other pain.
Be smart and be strong and exercise a lot to keep yourself really healthy.
How we take each other's love. Thinking anymore.
So we speak the language of jazz and we dance.
Forgetting to give back. Isn't it a pity? Some things take so long. But how do I explain? Too many people and see we're all the same because of all the tears their eyes can't hope to see the beauty that surrounds. Isn't it a pity?